In UNFO MUN, you can only give one roll call, which is present. Basic. No present and voting, nothing. Sirf present. If you're present, you just say you're present. Am I very clear with the roll call? Till this, any doubt?
Yes.
No, sir.
Okay, perfect. Second thing is quorum. Quorum. What does quorum mean? Is the minimum strength required for the committee to begin? See, it's an education stimulation. Anyways, you would be starting. But just for your knowledge, in UN for MUN, you need 1/4 of the strength. So these are the quorum fact is just a formality indeed. Because either of those will be beginning with the committee. So it's not like ki quorum nahi hai, toh we can't start at all. It's education stimulation. There are certain things which lie in place. So we'll begin. Am I clear with attendance and quorum?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Delegate of Chile, you have a doubt?
So, like, quorum is normally, like, I just wanted to ask, is this only there in normal, is this only there in MUN or is it there in the UNHRC, which session which takes place normally?
It's like, there everywhere. It's there everywhere, ma'am. It's like minimum strength required for us to start the committee. But you know, it's not that, how do I say, it's not a real this thing, right? It's academic stimulation. I'm just explaining for the purpose of your understanding. Okay, so I'm clear till these two parts. Just a minute. Yes. Am I clear till these two parts?
Perfect. Yes, you are.
Yes.
Yes.
Next, we'll go on to something which is just, again, like, you know, before we begin anything, we have to set the agenda. Now we only have one agenda in hand. So what does it mean? By default, like, you have to just raise a motion to set the agenda and you will have to vote in favor of it. This majorly comes into a lot of place when we have two agendas. So we vote upon it. If the first passes, it's first. If it's second, second passes second. If both don't pass, it's the first which we take. I'm sorry. Yeah. So am I clear till this? Motion to set agenda. So what you have to do after the roll call and the quorum is after the quorum roll call vice versa is established, I'll be saying that we look for a motion to set the agenda. You just have to raise a motion to set the agenda to discuss whatever the agenda is in the exact verbatims. One of y'all. Am I clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Can you repeat yes, the last sir. Part? I could not understand.
Motion to set the agenda. One of you have to just raise it with the exact verbatims. Delegate of so-and-so would like to raise a motion to set the agenda to discuss whatever is the exact verbatims of the agenda. I hope this is clear, right? Now, the next one, which next thing after setting the agenda is this is the next motion which we raise. Motion to open the floor for formal debate. Am I very clear? These are just the formality motions. I'll explain in detail what is formal debate in UN for MUN, what is informal debate, and what is the form of deviance which I would be doing from the procedure and the justification for the same. So I hope you are clear till this.
Yes, sir, you are.
Yes, sir.
Perfect, perfect.
Yes.
Now, after this, I'll explain all the structure of debate in UN for MUN. I want everyone to listen to me very carefully. Yes. So basically, in UN for MUN, debate is divided into two parts. Formal debate and an informal debate. Okay, now the formal debate would consist of yes, something called as a speakers list. You can name it anyhow, but I'll be naming it a speakers list since there's some distinction which I want from the conventional UN for me, UNAS procedure. This is UN for mine. Speakers list, we would have timing of 90 seconds. Now, since we have a huge committee.
Yeah.
Audible link. Yes. Since we'll be having a huge committee strength, I would be preferably taking each speech in an alphabetical order or in form of recognition. That is something which I would be again discussing upon. You can speak as many times you want in the speakers list according to the way you are recognized. Now, at the same time, informal debate consists of only one thing. Again, I'm making it clear. Formal debate consists of speakers list. And very important. One very important thing. No yields in formal debate. No yields. The concept of yields does not exist. Concept of yields is non-existent in UN for Women procedure. So if you have 90 seconds, you can exhaust your 90 seconds by speaking for 50, 40, 60, 70, or complete 90 seconds. Simple as that. But what I'll be mostly doing is after every speech in the speakers list, I want everyone to listen to me carefully. Each in the speakers list, I will ask the respective stakeholder of the country or the delegate of the country whether he is willing to entertain one question. If he is, I will take one question. Simple. This is the deviation which I'll be doing from the actual UN for Women procedure. Why? Because if there's no question and answer involved, it won't enable any form of debate. I believe we are not in an elocution, right? Every delegate just comes, speaks, sit, comes, speaks, sit, no. Hence, one question deviation policy we would apply. And it's up to the stakeholder. You can even say, no, I do not wish to entertain a question. That's fine. Just a minute. Give me a minute. Okay. Yes. Is it visible now, the screen?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, perfect. Perfect. So I hope till this, is this clear to everyone?
Yes, yeah. Sir.
On how our committee is going to work?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Perfect. Sir, I had a query.
Yes, ma'am.
Just one clarification. For the speakers list, would you be going according to recognition basis or alphabetical order?
Ma'am, that is for me to decide. I'll get...
All right. Thank you, sir.
I'll take 2-3 minutes. I'll just decide. I'm considering the committee strength that as a factor because I want everyone to get a chance to speak. That's my major concern. The procedure sadly does not enable. Before I proceed ahead, has everyone noted down till this? Can I erase it if you all don't mind?
Yes, sir.
Okay. One very important thing of UN for Women procedure, like I'm going to clarify it right now, you know, is the UN for MUN procedure is for more of negotiation / diplomatic courtesy. Apologies for spelling mistakes. And give me a second. And less of speeches. Okay, this is the main objective. You know, it works more like how the real UN works. So there's a lot of negotiation which happens among delegates and less of speeches. But I want you all to understand one thing. Since we are in an MUN, it's an academic stimulation. I have to mark you all as well. So we need to ensure that even adequate speech debating time is ensured. I, as an EB, can assure you there won't be compromise in the debating hours. Okay, but I hope this goes clear in your heads. Negotiation, I'll explain for all those who do not know what negotiation is. Negotiation is both the parties put their points in such a way that they come to middle ground and address that middle ground. This is negotiation. Now, what is another thing which we would be doing is, okay, we will go with the speakers list in an alphabetical order. We'll give everybody a chance to speak. So at least a worst case, you know, I hope you'll understand the concern of their 40 delegates, right? So again, by the end of the day, at least 40 speakers would get a chance to speak once, all of them, if we go by alphabetical order. Subject to the fact that if a stakeholder is not present at that point of time, by default, his chance goes away. Unless he's priorly informed me that he has a technical glitch or whatsoever. Okay. And one deviation is after every speech, I will ask the stakeholder if he wishes for a question and one question. We would be having one of the vice presidents would be maintaining a recognition sheet. So balanced recognition will happen. No need to worry about that. Now, coming ahead to the informal debate, which I explained to you all. I want everyone to listen to me very carefully. Consist of formal, informal session. How to raise a formal, informal session. Just give me a minute. Let's say after 4-5 speeches, let's say delegate of Togo. I don't think we have a Togo in the committee. Okay. I ask for motions. The only motion at this point, in this particular procedure, only motions which can be raised is formal informal session. What is formal informal session? Informal session in a formal way. That's how you perceive it. Before I go, just give me a minute. Okay. Let's say, now how will the delegate of Togo raise the formal informal session? Togo would like to suspend the meeting for a formal informal session. Total time -minutes. It does not have per speaker time. Now, why is it like this? It is basic diplomatic courtesy. Let's say if a delegate of Togo says he is given a total time of 30 minutes and there's no provision of first speaker and last speaker. So understand this first. And what happens is I recognize one delegate, which is the delegate of Nigeria. And delegate of Nigeria speaks for the entire 30 minutes. That is not this procedure is here for. The procedure is here. Procedure enables diplomatic courtesy. If the total time is 30 minutes, but you're recognized first, you have to ensure you speak for a sufficient time and then let others also speak. I have a special diplomatic courtesy is going to be marked. That's all I can say. But again, I will be observing for the first formal informal session. If I see there's absolute lack of diplomatic courtesy, I will use my discretion to enforce an individual speaker's time, per speaker time, to ensure everyone gets a chance to speak. Because for me, it's a concern because I have to mark y'all. This is the, at the most, this is something which I can do. I hope you're clear with what a formal informal session is. And this is the only type of session which can be raised. Up till here, any doubts?
Awesome.
Oh, sir, I had a doubt.
Yeah, ma'am, just a minute. I'll just stop my screen sharing for a minute. Yes. We go one by one. Who all have doubt, please raise your hand using the raise hand option. Yeah, Sudan followed by Sweden.
Yeah, actually, I had a doubt regarding that. During this the motion time, can a delegate raise a motion with specifying the particular delegate speaker time?
No, sir. That's the thing. No, this procedure does not allow that. The procedure, the UN Foreman procedure, shaped such a way where you can only mention the total time. What we'd be doing, sir, I will be observing first formal informal session. If I feel any delegate behaves in such a way where there's lack of diplomatic courtesy and the floor is not ensuring for people to speak, I will enforce per speaker time based on the total time. Yeah. Or I will enable the provision of you all putting in per speaker time. Simple. Why I'm not doing it initially? Because the procedure doesn't able to. If I find sufficient grounds for me to deflect from the original procedure, I will.
Okay. Yeah.
It's for the concern of the committee for sure, which I will take into account. So don't worry about that. We'll.
Yeah, I actually had one more thing to ask that the delegates, like, what's the maximum time of a motion can be raised? Like, it cannot be for 30 minutes, like, it's too big.
We can have it for 30 maximum. Maximum, we can have it for 40, I believe. Not more than 40 at a time is what I believe. Why? I'll tell you. I'll tell you the grounds of my calculation of 40. For everyone gets a minute to speak. I won't take more than 40. What I would rather suggest. Now, your question is, sir, what if I have points, I don't get to speak in that 40? Raise an extension. Extend it. There is no rule for extension in UN for one. Let me clarify this before I go ahead. However, I will allow extension to 50% of the total time. Simple. There's no rule in UN for one. I am enabling it because there are a lot of delegates in our committee and we want all of you to participate, right? For me to mark you on sufficient grounds. So I want all of you to listen to me carefully because I will be deflecting from the original procedures at certain points. Tomorrow, I do not want you to learn wrong things and go out. Rather, understand why the EB has deflected from the procedure and why. So with that, we'll move on to the next doubt, delegate of Sweden.
Yes, sir. My first question being, if a delegate raises a motion, will that delegate be given the option of going first?
Nothing of that sort, ma'am.
So it is totally on recognition basis?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So, sir, my second question, once a delegate is being recognized, suppose a delegate has spoken for 2 minutes and the speech has ended. So after that, will the executive board be recognizing more speakers or does the delegate decide who has to speak next?
No, ma'am. Why would the delegate be given a freedom to decide who's going to speak next? I don't understand in what context. So we won't be having. I'll be making a list. The formal, informal, I'll be maintaining a list. Let's say, I'll explain you all. Let's say, okay, delegate of Sweden itself, she's raised a topic on XYZ. I'm not going to give you all any substantive suggestions because it'll be like a hint from my end. I don't want to do that. Any random topic to discuss about the zoos present in, what do I say? Discuss wildlife sanctuaries across the world. Random topic I'm just taking for a total time of 30 minutes. What I'll do, I'll ask delegates wishing to speak. I will note the names. Then the timer initially will start for 30 minutes. Getting it? Let's say a rapporteur, she'll be screen sharing it. She'll screen share for 30 minutes. So 30 se countdown chalu hoga. While the countdown goes on, the delegates give speeches. If Sweden finish, we call on next. If next delegate finish, we call on next. This will happen till the time 30 minutes get over. Now, if in the first session, I witness a lack of diplomatic courtesy, that's when I will enforce the per speaker time. Simple. This will only happen if I witness it in first session. But if as a committee, you all have understood what diplomatic courtesy is, it's a broad concept I understand. I can't explain in one session, nor can anyone understand in one session, being on a practical side. But take consideration of all the stakeholders involved. You all have to be mutually understanding enough ki hada ek ek minute baat karke or 1.5 minutes or 2 minutes. Accordingly, we'll end our speech. Accordingly, we'll structure our speech. Simple. In formal, informal, I won't be entertaining questions. The questions pro forma majorly would be in speakers list. If I'm going to take that diversion, I'll inform you all on day. But be prepared. Be prepared to ask questions. Be ready. That provision I'll somehow enable. Any more doubts, delegate of Sweden, before we move on to next two delegates?
Oh, no, sir. Everything has been clarified.
Okay. Delegate of Chile. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, sir, while a person asked, like you gave an example about Togo during for the formal informal session, that like the delegate of that particular country will speak on the agenda only, or he can raise any question or any doubt as such?
Ma'am, I didn't get you. Like the subtopic which he's raising.
Yes, yes. Like, will it be related to the agenda of the session?
It has to be, right, ma'am. It has to be related to the agenda. Or I won't take it on order, right, ma'am?
Mm-hmm.
We're not here just to have gathering and picnic. Nahi hai na, matlab picnic hoti to we would have had good amount of discussion on random things. It would have been a good outing for all of us, virtual outing probably. But no, we will be only discussing related to agenda.
Okay.
That is somewhere all these subtopics have to be related to what our agenda is and have to be related to what human rights is in general.
Okay. Okay. Thank
basic
you.
Clarity. I hope that answers
your doubt. Yes.
The leader of Sudan.
Yeah, I actually have one more doubt that if a particular country has more than one doubt to a specific country, how can the country ask the question? Because you are giving the only one question at a time, right?
Okay. There are three ways which you can do. The first way is to ask him via, I'll explain cheat system. You can ask him via cheat. We won't call it a cheat. You can call it a diplomatic note probably. It's called L document. So you can call it diplomatic note. You can ask each other. I'll explain that. One is via cheat. Second is you can mutually clarify it. Third, you can address your question in the speech you're making. Take just 10 seconds out and state the question in your speech and then continue with your speech. I hope, sir, that answers your doubt.
Yeah, thank you.
Delegate of Sudan? Hello?
No, yeah, it's over.
Yeah, it's clear, sir?
Yeah.
Thank you. Any further doubts before I go ahead?
Sir, I had one more doubt. So in the formal debate, will you be completing the full speakers list and then asking for motions for informal debate or in between only?
No, ma'am. Four to five speakers.
Okay, thank you.
And this. Just a minute. Yes, before we proceeded, there is one more thing which I would like to state. What we would be doing is every 4 to 5 speakers, one formal informal session. Okay. For all those who have previously done MUNS but not done a UN for MUN, formal informal with a subtopic and total time is like your moderated caucus. Better way to understand. Okay. Now, before I proceed ahead, let's understand something. What if you want to discuss something amongst you all mutually and do not want the EB to like, it shouldn't be moderated at all. What you will do in that case? Let me tell you, when you raise motion, if you raise a formal informal with just the total time and not mentioning the subtopic, it by defaultly means you all want to discuss something amongst yourself. I'll be considering it as an unmod. Simple. Am I very clear?
Yes, sir.
Formal, informal, with a subtopic and total time is like your moderated caucus. Simple. It's like you want to discuss a specific subtopic. But you all want to discuss something amongst yourself. You all raise a formal, informal with just the total time and no subtopic. Am I very clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, this is all about what we'd be basically doing. We'd be having the formal debate going on. Simultaneously, we'll switch to informal. Back to formal, informal. Back to formal, informal. Now, UN for MUN, again, this is the third time I think I'm telling, aims on building consensus, negotiation. What I want you all to do, prevent a lot of committee time from going in vain, and rather from a lot of committee time getting wasted. Once this group gets opened up, please discuss productively the subtopics which all want to come so that our time does not get wasted failing the motions. It goes productively in giving speeches. It goes productive in usage. Very clear.
So, sir, basically, we have to decide previous before the conference only that what all subtopics we will be discussing.
That is what I would recommend. I'll tell you the reason why. Two things. Okay. Let me make this clear for all those who think I won't reveal the marking scheme before I go ahead for two reasons. One, a delegate's perspective only changes once the marking scheme comes. I won't be able to see the original perspective of the delegate, which I don't encourage. Second thing, I don't feel it's fair pre-conference I reveal any kind of marking scheme. It's not fair. Before I go ahead, just one basic insight. You won't be marked, oh, just because, example, oh, this delegate raised a formal informal session. Oh, he's the best del of the committee. No. For me, it does not matter who raises the motion. Have diplomatic courtesy, negotiate. Convince the committee at a point that why is your solution more better? How is it feasible? To what extent you're negotiating? Am I very clear?
Yes, sir.
What is expected out of you all? What is negotiation? Am I very clear? Come to middle grounds. Pick the subtopics very nicely so that it goes smooth. I take on speakers list. When I look for formal informal, everybody's on a consensus. We take in one formal informal session nicely, productively. And I give the freedom. If the committee feels, if the committee has any problem, you can approach me. You can tell me, sir, this is a problem. Sir, we are not comfortable with this part of the procedure. If the entire committee feels there's a problem, like, you know, this part of the procedure is not enabling us something. If the whole committee wishes for certain changes, I will be ready to do. There are certain changes to the best of my capacity and ability, I'm doing it. Further going ahead, I explained you all the types of debate, right? If I'm not wrong. Yes. Now, just a minute. Everybody made a note of this, right? Can I clear this off?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Before I go ahead, I'll be explaining you the points and privileges. Give me a minute. Yes. Apologies for the spelling errors. Please ignore that. Apologies for spelling this. I'll explain all this. Like, I want to focus more on explanation. So I'm just. Okay. So basically, you have three privileges and three rights. Let me make this clear. If these are frivolously used, I can even suspend them. Making this very clear right now itself. Yes. First is a point of inquiry. Now, if you have a procedural doubt, sir, what is going to happen next? Sir, who is recognized next? You can raise always a point of inquiry. Procedural doubt. Next you have is a point of personal privilege. Just ignore my spelling mistakes. This is the only point can interrupt a speaker from speaking in actual sense. Now, point of personal privilege is when, in general, in offline MUH, when there's too much of disturbance, there's too much of heat, sir, I want the fan on, AC on, physical discomfort. In case of this stimulation, since it's happening virtual, it will only be if someone is not audible. Okay. The third one is on me. If I've done any procedural errors, you can raise it on me. So point of order on the EB, this is a mistake. I take it. There's no egos in it. Everyone's a human, right? So let's be the only way to communicate. Simple. I won't take any points orally. Why? To prevent disruption in committee. Simple. I have reasons behind everything what I'm doing. I expect all delegates to pay attention to the reason carefully. Okay. Are these clear? Okay, before I go ahead, right of reply won't be there in the committee because on being on a practical perspective, I don't think there is, I won't be entertaining. I won't say right to reply won't be there. Just a minute. Won't be entertained at a normal capacity, only in extreme cases. So you all have to just send a right of reply if you feel. See, this is again a very stupid thing. I don't agree with this. How can one statement breach your country's sovereignty practically? Let's understand what is sovereignty. You being like, you have the freedom to govern your country independently. Now me just by telling a statement, your sovereign rights aren't going to get lost here. Let's be practical here. Sovereignty is such a big term in international law and IRs. So let's not just get into those angles. Technically, I won't be taking right of reply, but right of reply is something which could be exercised if your head of state is inserted, which is rare. I'm not expecting in this. I'm expecting more sound, resonant debate regarding the agenda, going into all the nuances of the agenda. I hope this is clear. Till this, any doubts, you all can raise your hand. Okay, okay, just a minute. I'll just stop the screen sharing because there are doubts, I believe. Yes. Yes, we will have Poland first.
So I've never, good evening, AB. So I've never done UN4 before. So what is the order is like when you are pointing out some factual inaccuracy? So how do we do that here?
Sir, basically two ways. You can use your speeches to point it out. Secondly, you can clarify it via chit. Simple, sir.
So how do we don't put any point on that. We just write there's a factual inaccuracy.
You don't write to me. I will explain you when it comes to chit, if that's fine with you. One is you can use your speeches. I'll explain in the second way in detail. Is that fine, Delegate of Poland?
Yes, sir. And what about the point of information that we that is also through chit? The same.
The point of information does not exist in UN for Monday.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
I explained.
What is the,
what I'm suggesting, there are three ways to ask a question. I think I repeated it previously. I'll repeat it again. One is you can use the chit. Second, you can informally clarify. Third, you can use your speech just to just state the question in your speech. Make it a part of your speech. Simple. I hope that answers the question, Delegate of Poland.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. I'll come to the chits. Don't worry at all. Delegate of France, followed by Chile.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, my question is that, as you said, that the point of privilege is the like only point which can interrupt a speaker. So, sir, for points of privilege, we don't have to use the Zoom chat box.
You can use the Zoom chat box. You have to use Zoom chat box for all the points. So my constant attention would be on Zoom chat box. I'll come to chits. I'll explain you all a better remedy on how. Now you'll be like, sir, there'll be so much communication on Zoom. How are you going to ensure the chat box is on place, right? I'll come to that, sir. Don't worry at all.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, Delegate of Chile, your doubt?
No, sir. I forgot to switch it off. That reason.
Fair. No worries. What we'll do is we'll proceed to the further part of the procedure. Is points and privileges clear in UN Foreman? See, right of reply is not technically expected, but if it comes, I will rule upon it for sure. But I don't think it's necessary and it's a bit fictional in nature. Let me make this very clear. Right of reply, like just by telling something to a head of state, uska nahi hota sovereignty breach, yaar, guys, understand this. Think from very broad side, not from a narrow side. Am I very clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. There is something more which I would come up to before I go ahead. Does the committee... See, this is something I leave up to committee because UN for Man at certain areas, I need to give the delegates that freedom. Do you all want me to go alphabetical order in the speakers list or do you all want me to go by recognition system in the speakers list?
Recognition system.
I think recognition would be better.
So recognition would be preferred by me.
Okay. What we'll do, simple. I'll keep it very simple. See, the entire committee is not present here, right? First thing which I'd be voting upon is do you all want recognition system or do you all want alphabetical order? Build consensus on it. On an informal note, there would be voting which would happen. I'll explain you by voting what. See, let's say I've clicked on yes. If you can see beside my name in the participant column, I have voted, right? this is the way how it's going to work. You can vote yes or probably no, getting it. This is how our voting system would work, and I would be accordingly, I'd be expecting you all to vote on first thing is this. Okay. Second thing, in regards to questions, for sure, yes. The third very important thing is in regards with questions during formal sessions. Do you all want questions during formal informal sessions? I'm sorry, formal informal sessions. Okay. These two things you'll be voting upon amongst yourself, internally come to consensus. If it's good, if you don't even enter into some informal voting, on behalf of every delegate, one delegate can just inform me, ki, sir, we want this, this, this. We want speakers list to go in an alphabetical order or vice versa, whatever. Please, okay, just a request. Okay, wrap your tier.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, ma'am. Just a request. Can you just note two things down and put this up in the group?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. The first thing is on whether or not to have the speakers list in accordance with alphabetical order or recognition system.
Yes, sir.
Second thing is whether or not to have questions in formal informal session.
Yes, sir.
Just a request. So, yeah, these are the two things which delegates have to come to consensus. Just mention that delegates to just discuss and come to consensus on these two following things, since an informal vote in regards to these two things would be taken before the committee begins.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You made a note of it, ma'am?
Yes.
Perfect. Delegates, these two things are something which I want you all to develop consensus on. I hope I'm very clear with what we're going up to. There's a third thing. Yes, sir, that is very clear. I don't think I need to mention that. That is something which I've informed. Hence, I'm not mentioning specifically. Delegate of Ukraine, this is something which the delegates by default should understand once they listen to UN format. Ki topics pe consensus lana hi hai. We don't want to compromise debating time for just building consensus time and again. What you build consensus on, your views on this particular subtopic, you build consensus on that rather than just deciding the subtopic. We'll proceed to the next most important thing is chits, or rather I call it as diplomatic notes. I hope everyone has noted this down. Can I just erase it off?
Just a minute.
Yeah. Take your time. Let me know once you've noted it down, so I'll proceed ahead.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, just a small doubt. Actually, yeah. I briefly had to go somewhere for something important. So within the last 2 minutes, have you discussed anything very important? Last 2 minutes only.
Yes, sir. It's been discussed, sir. What I would rather suggest is there are two things on which delegates have, you all have to build consensus amongst yourself. And that is something which I've given to the rapporteur. Ma'am will put it up in the group, so you can have a look at it. You don't need to worry about it, sir.
Thank you so much, sir.
Perfect. So has everyone noted this down? Can I erase this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Perfect. So this is something called as interesting. In MUNS, you call it as chits, or I would call it a better name, diplomatic note. What is it basically? It is from... There are two types of chits which can be sent. Again, I'm making it this very clear. I will call it chits for your purpose, for your easy communication. one is from one delegate to another. Second form of chit is from one delegate to another via executive board. Okay. How does a chit is like, you know, from name of the country to, I am so sorry, I know my screen has gone down just a minute. Yeah, now it's visible.
Yes, sir.
Just a minute. I'm so sorry. Format of a chit. Yeah, from to and whatever is the content. Okay, this is how a chit goes. Okay, you can use this to ask your questions to each other. Now, where it comes a very interesting part. I have taken this decision and the reason why I have taken. Chits will be communicated. Let's say, example, I am delegate of Togo and let's say we have a delegate of Belgium. I want to ask him certain question, clarify something. You just message to him on his WhatsApp number. So what I would suggest you all to do is once the group opens up, just introduce yourself. So everyone knows this is delegate of Fiji karke. So whatever communication personally you have to do, do it via your WhatsApp. If you want something to bring it to the notice, just see, let's say I'm sending a chit to some my known fellow delegate of Belgium's WhatsApp number with his consent, obviously. You write the content down. You send it on his WhatsApp. He will answer on your personal communication, not necessary WhatsApp. Again, you can have it even on Zoom. If you want it via EB, you have to just write via EB, communicate it. After the communication is complete, you have to copy paste the entire chat, mail it on a mail ID, which I'll be giving. And I'll give you all 40 minutes ka window after the end of the day to mail it. So no chat falls up on the official HRC group. And the Zoom chat for me especially doesn't get flooded. Because I will miss out on points since I have allowed points on chit. This is something which I recommend exclusively to be done on WhatsApp. But again, I leave it to your freedom because some might be logged in through phones. So it might not be pretty convenient for them, right? So do it either via WhatsApp or Zoom at your personal capacity. If it's via EB, continue the conversation. Just bring it to my notice when the thread is complete. What do I mean by the thread is complete? Now from to... तुम एक जन ने दूसरे को भेजा तो दूसरा भी वापस जवाब देगा फ्रॉम हिम टू हर आंसर ब्ला 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 फिर वापस फ्रॉम टू वापस जवाब देगा सो व्हाट यू कैन डू इज कॉपी पेस्ट दिस एंटायर थिंग एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द डे यू जस्ट कैन मेल इट टू मी एम आई वेरी क्लियर
यस सर
यस
सर दिस इज टू इवन सिंप्लीफाई योर प्रोसेस डू यू ऑल रियलाइज
Yes, sir.
I hope I am very clear till this. I will just summarize about the paperwork and I'll take exclusively doubts. Even I will address some form of research doubts also, no worries. I won't give substantive guidance, but I'll address research doubts and give suggestions for sure. Paperwork, you have two forms of paperwork. One is kind of informal in nature, which is a working paper. It just consists of authors, that's it. Second is formal, which is resolution. Note, very important, only member nations of HRC can sponsor a draft resolution. Now, some observers will ask me, sir, I'm an observer, but I can't sponsor a draft resolution. What you can do? You can author a working paper. Am I very clear? Yes. At this point, these two documents first need to be introduced and they can be only discussed via the same thing, formal, informal session. Now, rapporteur, ma'am, just a request. Amidst the two things which delegates had to decide, can you note down a third thing? yes, on whether should there be Q and whether do they want Q and A session for paperwork, because UN Foreman prohibits, UN Foreman is silent on whether to have Q and A session. These are the three things which you all have to come into consensus. I will take the voting for the same. Rapporteur ma'am, just a request, please put it up on the HRC group, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. So what this is, I hope this is very clear till here. The format of working paper and resolution we'll discuss tomorrow. One very, very important thing. One very, very important thing. Paper documentation would be only accepted if there has been sufficient debate. This is a message on my behalf to all of you. Simple. It's fine if you'll get documentation on the second day, but first day debate karo acche se, discuss karo. You're here for negotiating, negotiate, come to solutions, come discuss, establish the problems of this agenda. Am I very clear?
Yes, sir.
Has the,
yes, sir,
the CHITS format been understood properly?
Yes, sir.
It's not necessary you need to use your WhatsApp. You can even use your Zoom, but Zoom pe everybody pe kuch nahi dalna hai tum logo ko. Other than points. Sirf daloge tum point of inquiry, point of personal privilege. Ye. Apart from that, everybody pe kuch nahi aayega. Zoom ke private chat pe you can have your CHITS system going on. You just have to copy paste it and mail it to me. And if one CHIT goes from one nation to another, if it's not via EB, you don't need to mail me that. You only need to mail me those CHITs which are going, which you want via EB to be noticed. Getting it? The second form of CHITs. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? Sir. Do you all want me to explain again? I feel there's a bit of confusion that you all are having.
Sir, one doubt I had.
Okay, I'll come to doubts. Wait, I'll just stop screen sharing because I can't see. Yes, who just raise your hand. Just raise your hand. It becomes easy for me. Raise hand option, sir. Whoever has a doubt. Amazing. Chile, delegate of Chile.
Sir, I had a doubt regarding the paperwork. The paperwork should be submitted by each and every delegate who is like...
Not mandatory, ma'am. Generally, you all have to negotiate, come together and then give out a paperwork.
Okay, together you'll form one paper, like one draft to be submitted to the executive.
No, ma'am. Again, it's not necessary. See, there might be two blocks in this agenda. One block might come with one paperwork, second might come with second.
Okay.
Ideally, all of you all should come with one paper. Ideally, but it's a very idealistic situation for me to hear, say, or comment. And I don't restrict on anyone's freedom. But when you come up with a paperwork, come up with consensus, negotiate, deliberate, come with nations who have like foreign policies just like you.
Okay.
Delegate of Sweden.
Also, I had one doubt being, since member nations cannot sponsor a resolution, so by default, we would be working on a working paper.
Ma'am, so, observers can't sponsor a resolution, ma'am, not member nations.
Observers. Sorry, sir. So, for the working paper, will individual ones be accepted, or is there a minimum limit as to how many authors can come together for one working paper?
Since it's a committee of 40, I would be okay with three authors coming together. It's fine with me.
All right. Thank you so much, sir.
Three authors for working paper, but maximum two sponsors for the resolution, not more than that. Delegate of Sudan.
Yes, sir. I have a doubt that whether the EB will accept recommendation paper and the position paper from the delegates.
Sir, I won't be taking position paper because I'll be fair with you all. Because firstly, I want you all to focus more on the negotiation and your speeches rather than some pre-conference document. So no such documents would be accepted. I want you all to heartily, focusedly research and come. That's it. I'm not going to pressurize all to give me position paper and stuff. No.
It's a recommendation paper.
Why? Sir, what is a recommendation paper first? Define a recommendation paper for me, sir.
Sir, a recommendation paper is basically when a member nation recommends few laws that needs to be changed or needs to be bring into the conference. Basically, it's a like a resolution from a delegate.
Sir, why can't it be included in the resolution then? Why do we take a separate paper? Doesn't it dilute the purpose of a resolution, sir?
Sir, but many a times, like a particular delegate's points are not taken in front of in a resolution, right?
Sir, that's where your negotiation skills comes in, right, sir? See, delegates understand. That's what I'm saying. I really respect, sir. I know your solutions. You want to contribute, and I really acknowledge it's good. You should, but sir, what is delegate of Sudan's capacity to negotiate and convince other stakeholders is what the procedure has been designed. Is what the UN is here for. Achieve universal solidarity. Sab aao ek saath. Come together on this. Okay, fine. You have to see, this is what. Something might be feasible for your country, but something might not be feasible for the other country. But there is something which is feasible for both the countries. That is something which you have to come to. Understand this.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, yeah. Delegate of Poland. Delegate of Poland.
So first thing, I have two doubts. So first is that for the working paper, is there any sort of format or anything?
No, sir. Working paper doesn't have any format. Resolution has format. I won't teach that now. It's too much of headache. Right now, you all will have knowing too many things for you all on your head right now. I'll guide you all the reso format tomorrow on this first day evening or probably second day morning, whatsoever, whichever is suitable according to the conference timings. Don't come up with pre-working papers. That's my humble request. Wait, see how the committee goes ahead with. Try establish a direction for the committee. Understand that. And before I go ahead, one more thing. Whatever you all discuss in WhatsApp lobbying does not have marks for me. I'm not going to read, delegate of Chile messaged this. I'll give her 5 points. Get over this point. Making this very clear and straight upfront, being very honest rather. Negotiate. Make things simpler for the committee. Make things such a which enables debate time.
Sir, another doubt.
Yeah, go ahead.
So can we, instead of copying and emailing, can we send the screenshots in WhatsApp? We'll take care about the not EB ones.
Sir, again, just a minute, sir. The problem, I'll tell you what, if you send me screenshots, it's again too much for me, right? I know we have 3 EBs. But rather, if you mail only the via EB ones, one of us would really make good note of it. And it's convenient to make note via mail. You're getting it. If via WhatsApp, I get flooded with tons of screenshots, it's impractical for me to make a note, right? Email is a bit more convenient method according to us. That's why I've given that. But don't worry regarding the window. 40 to 45 minutes after the day one ends, you'll get the time to mail.
Okay.
Are okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Anytime. Are okay. Korea? Delhi or South Korea?
Thank you, sir. I would like to ask, like, will there be a block formation and will we have to work on a common paper, like if we are giving a resolution?
Sir, see, basically, generally, it's how things work in an MUN is basically you have to read about your country and find out who are your allies, who do not get along with you. Based on that, you form a lobby, you form a bloc with similar like-minded solutions. Convincing the other bloc to come on a middle ground or probably convincing that your solution is better. These all are the arts of diplomacy, diplomatic courtesy. You negotiate. So again, I do not know how you're going to form blocs. That is something which I'm not here to interpret right now. I want to know on the day. This is something which I won't comment on. It's up to you all how you want to form blocs. Delegate of Sweden.
Oh, sir, this is more like a suggestion. Since we'll be having formal, informal sessions. So would the executive board be fine if the topics for the formal, informal sessions will be given around like on Friday evening so that the committee does not waste time on voting as we already will be having consensus on few topics.
Ma'am, I don't mind. To be very honest, delegate, I don't mind. But the thing is, No, you all have to discuss in that way. You all have to negotiate in that way. You all come up with the subtopics in such a span of time. If you all can, well and good. You all just decide the subtopics for formal informal. Keep it ready. Whenever I ask for formal informal, raise them. Simple. It's good. I rather appreciate if it comes on 30th. It's good. The main reason why I want formal informal topics to be pre-decided, I don't want committee time getting wasted on you all discussing with two delegates shouting, muting their mics, unmuting their mics. Doesn't make sense to me. Simple. Discuss it. Get on it. Debate good on it. Give good speeches on it. Negotiate on the matter, subject matter, not on what subject is to be discussed. That's the reason why I'm saying pre-decide kar lo formal informal ke topics. You have 4 days time here. Why 30th? 31st ka morning tak decide karo. Before we open the session, before we set the agenda, discuss it till the time roll call is taken. It's fine with me. But pre-decide it nicely so that there's a direction established. Committee goes smoothly. You all give me the opportunity to really mark you all on speeches, not just on what you're who's going to decide. And I'm making it very clear. Aisa kuch nahi hai ki who raises the topic gets the best. There's nothing of that sort. Get that out of your head right now. For me, it does not matter who raises what topics. For me, it's what you speak, your diplomatic courtesy, your research, your analysis, your understanding of the agenda. These are the things that matter to me as an executive board, making it very clear. And trust me, a very in-depth score sheet, I even keep a separate working mark sheet where I mark each speeches. So don't worry, you will be marked thoroughly. And after the closing, you all can contact me. I'll be open to give justification, and I've done that in past. So don't worry about those things. We'll go with Delegate of UK's doubt.
Hello, sir. Thank you. So, is there any way that a non-member state, which is an observer state, is involved in the resolution process such that you recognize it?
You can give a speech on it during its form. But if the resolution is discussed in the form of formal informal session, and I may give the power, but no, this is something again, I'll explain on the day one, sir, if that's fine with you, because resolution is something pretty advanced. I do not want to just brainstorm you all with a lot of things.
Okay, sir, no problem.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Don't worry, I will explain it. And observers, mark my words, you don't need to be worried. I understand the symbolic importance of an observer in an HRC. Marking won't be affected. Mark my words. Marking won't be affected.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Delegate of Poland and Sudan.
Yes, sir. Sir, my doubt is about the substantive sheets. How do we send you the substantive sheets?
Mail, sir. Mail.
Okay, sir.
What you can do, sir, simple. Let's say there are total 4 formal sessions which have happened. Okay, formal informal sessions in day one. And let's say a delegate has given 1 speech in the speakers list. Total, you have given 5 speeches. You might have something additional to add. Copy all that in 1 mail, substantive chit dal ke ek mail mein bhejna din ka. Don't send me 5 different mails of substantive chit. 1 mail mein include everything.
Sure, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Delegate Sudan.
Sir, can we include annexures in our resolutions?
You can, but I'm preferably not looking for it. I will come to resolutions tomorrow, if that's fine, on the day, first day. Because why I'm telling you, the reason is very simple. If I right now start talking about resolutions, you all will forget what are the primary tasks which you all as delegates have to complete. I hope you all are getting it, what I'm trying to say.
Yes, sir.
Let's just wait for basic established debate. Well, discuss, deliberate, negotiate, then think, and let's have good session on discussing paperwork. After the session ends, I will take 30 minutes and discuss paperwork with you all. That's of primary importance to me. Don't worry, but please ensure that you all debate sufficient for me to accept paperwork.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.
We will have Delegate of UK, is your doubt cleared, sir?
Yes, sir, it is. I'll wait for the first day.
Okay. I'll just lower your hand. Yeah. Delegate of Chile.
Followed by India. Sir, yeah.
Sir, so like actually it's my first time attending an MUN as such, and I've never attended one. So I was confused, like how will I go, like if I have, you said there are in the first starting only before you told like we have 90 seconds to speak in a formal debate as such, in a formal debate. So how we will go with our research list? So just a hint or a help, sir.
Okay, I will give it. I'll give it, ma'am. Don't worry. Let me just complete all the doubts. I'll definitely give it for all the first timers. How many first timers more are there? Just raise your hand. Be honest. It's nothing wrong. Don't need to worry. Just raise your hand. Yes, that's the way. Yes, you all raise your hand. Exactly why I want you all to raise. So most of you all are first timers. Am I right? Don't worry at all. I will give you all guidelines on how to research. No worries. No worries. No worries. Okay. We had a doubt from Delegate of India. Everyone lower your hand. Apart from those who have doubts. Then I'll move on to the question asked by Delegate of Chile. I'll answer it properly. Don't worry at all. This is fine. This is absolutely fine. Delegate of India, sir, your doubt.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Sir, can you elaborate for the benefit of the committee and for me as well, what substantive cheats entail?
Okay. So basically substantive cheat is, let's say you have spoken for a particular span of time, but you have more content to add on to your research. You couldn't add because your time got over. You basically compile it and bring it to the notice of the EB. Simple. That is a form of a cheat. You do it.
So that's all, right?
Yeah, that's all. Nothing
format important. To be adhered to or something like that.
Huh. Now, however, just the whatever cheat discussion you all would be having and just mailing it across to me, whichever are only via EB ones. Again, I'm saying from India to Chile, from Chile to India, if they both feel it's not via EB cheat, you don't need to mail it. But if Chile has mailed it to Delegate of Bahamas via EB, she wants the EB to note, it's some very substantive content which is questioned Bahamas on or something like that. That is the one which Delegate of Chile has to mail after the thread is complete. Only those chits come to me. Rest chits don't come to me. Personal to personal, which EB has to not make a note, don't mail it to me. Substantive chit is you're adding some more substance to your speech which got left out. And you want to bring it to the notice of the EB. That does not mean tum 10 paragraph Google ke copy paste karke mujhe bhejoge. No.
Haan, sir.
I can practically understand ki itna koi nahi bol sakta hai 2 minute mein. I understand. But ek ya 2 paragraph maximum substantive chit per speech you have missed out. Max. Nothing more than that.
Sure, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Delegate of Bahamas, your doubt? Delegate of Bahamas?
Sir, I have no doubt. Actually, I'm the first timer, so I had similar doubt.
Okay. I will guide you all. Don't worry. I believe there are a lot of first timers. So what I will do is I'll just give you all a basic outline. No need to worry. Before that, have you all seen the video which the OCS put? A research, how to research by Ishan Chitnis, sir. It's pretty comprehensive when it covers all the aspects. How many of you have seen it? Honestly, kitne log ne dekha hai? Because it's very helpful. That's why I'm asking you all this question. Okay. Before I go, I won't dwell into that depth because of paucity of time, but it's very well explained in depth and in a very slow and a concise manner. So what I would suggest, all those who have not seen, to see that video. Is there any other procedural doubts? Resolution ka tension mat lo, main format first day ke baad acche se calmly samjhaunga. Koi nahi, I don't want to brainstorm you all, confuse you all. I am keeping it very simple. If there are any more doubts, if there are any more doubts regarding procedure, please let me know, or else I'll go in short about research in a simple way. Delegate of Libya.
Yes, sir. So you said the motions have to be pre-decided, right?
So I can bring them up
on...
Apologies. It's just recommended that it needs to be pre-decided. Yeah.
Okay. So I can bring them up randomly. I don't have to muster support for it.
No, ma'am. It is voted upon. Motions are voted upon.
No, like prior. I mean, I can just write it down on my own and raise it. And then we can discuss upon it, right? I don't have to gather support or something.
I'll explain this again. Let's say you raise a motion for formal informal session. it is voted upon. For a motion of formal informal to pass, you need simple majority. What is simple majority? 50% of the total strength present in the committee. So why am I telling you all to pre-decide is pre-build consensus so that it is easy. While your vote, the motion gets passed and we don't waste time. If randomly motions are raised without the committee's knowledge or without the committee interested in discussing it, there are higher chances the motion might fail. And if continuously motions fail, I have to revert back to the speakers list. And there is no thing called order of disruption here. In what order I recognize, in that order, formal informal sessions come to me. If I recognize Philippines followed by India followed by Japan, Philippines formal informal will get voted first, India and then Japan. Simple majority to pass. If the first one passes, the rest to by default get discarded. That's why I say pre-decide. Now what will happen, I'll tell you all. If you don't pre-decide and you'll just get topics to me on day, it's quite obvious many stakeholders are not aware of it. They might not want to discuss on it. It won't get passed. We again revert back to speakers list. After some speakers, we again get back to this. But even in that case, if it doesn't get passed, we are wasting committee time, isn't it? Just on what to discuss. Rather than debating on what to discuss, if you all could focus on each aspect of what is being discussed, it's what more advisable.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, we can keep... Sorry.
Yeah, Delegate of Libya. Go ahead. No problem.
Sir, I was saying I'm Poland, actually.
Oh, apologies, sir. Yes.
Sir, so I was saying that we can, with the discretion of yours, so we can keep a Zoom meeting in advance before the this conference about deciding these agenda sub-agendas. We can do that.
That and all comes to negotiation, right? That's something you all can do it by yourself on mutual consensus. You all don't need to like inform me, sir, we are keeping a Zoom meeting. The group will open up, hopefully after the ROP session, the OC will look into it. Once the group is open, you all can do however you want. You all can discuss amongst yourself. Call, Zoom, WhatsApp, whatever you all want. Is there any other doubt?
So, except the resolution powers, is there any difference between an observer nation and a member state?
Sir, basically voting rights in regards with general. Apart from voting rights, you don't have any difference. So while the voting is there, you might have to leave the breakout room or something of that sort. I'll figure out on that. Observers don't get a right to vote. Apart from that, okay, there are two types of voting. The voting on the actual resolution. Now, what is the meaning of actual resolution is the one which you all make and which is binding. Okay, which is binding per se by men. I mean, that is official document. That is called substantive voting or normal voting on the paperwork. Before I got, working papers are not voted upon. Working papers are not voted upon. They're just introduced and discussed. When I ask for a formal informal session, vote, all those in favor and against, it is mandatory for everyone to vote. That is called procedural voting. Procedure ka voting kar rahe ho, right? Formal informal ka. Paperwork ko likhe, I will discuss later. Don't worry. Be rest assured. I will personally discuss. Even if you don't want, I'll discuss with you.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Any more doubts?
Sir, so I think all the important parts are covered. Actually, I have to go somewhere. So all the important parts are covered, right?
Yes, sir. But since there are many first timers, they want some insights on how to...
Yes, I understand that. I totally understand. So, sir, for me, like, I'm not a first timer. So can I leave,
okay, sir,
actually?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's your freedom, sir. It's your freedom. You can fully leave, sir. You can completely leave. Sir, you're a representative of a sovereign nation. So, I'll move on to how to research session, like in a simple and a quiet manner. On a point of orders can only be raised on resolution if they're outside the mandate. There is no point raising a point of order on a working paper. It's anyways not a formal document. So I hope that answers the question. Delegate of Sudan.
Yes, sir. I had one important doubt to ask, that how seriously are you gonna take the foreign policies? Like, are you okay with the whole committee forming up just one block?
Sir, I will take foreign policy very seriously, no, sir. At the same time, I'm even going to take very seriously diplomatic courtesy, right, sir? Now, sir, understand something. Foreign policy is something which is not defined in a book or a document, right? It depends from country to country, from agenda to agenda, right? So it requires in-depth analysis. And in this particular situation, there's a lot of things that you need to analyze and discuss. I'll be taking foreign policy at a very serious note.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Fair. I will move on to how to research in a simple manner. I'll keep it very simple. I'm writing certain things. You all can follow it down. But please see that video on how to research. It's very insightful. Basically, your research is divided into three parts. Country-based research, committee-based research, agenda-based research. In country-based research, you can research on the complete foreign policy of this country, statements that your country has given on behalf of, on this issue, on various issues which are relevant in regards, and your relationship of your countries with other countries. I hope that's clear with what country-based research means. Committee-based is what are the powers and functions of UNHRC. Simple. Simple. And about the UNHRC, kitne members hote, kya hai, kaisa kaam karta committee. Simple. Agenda-based research is you can form a for. See, again, you can follow a PESTEL analysis. Now, what does PESTEL analysis stand for? Can anyone tell me? Can anyone tell me what is PESTEL?
Sir, I'm not very sure, but I can try.
Achha, okay, go ahead. I'm completely typed it out, so you can go ahead, sir.
Okay, so first is P, political and economic. Then S is social. T is, I think, technological. E is environmental. And the other E is economic. And L is legal.
Oh, yes. Correct. Perfect. So you can do this form of analysis. Read about your agenda. And once you all finalize your subtopics, prepare speeches on them and come read a lot of articles, 10 to 15 articles padho, read past resolutions, read the laws of your country in regards with this, read the position of the particular ethnic minorities which we are going to specially emphasize. Are there any other particular kind of ethnic minorities? Prepare 10 to 15 speeches. But this is more of negotiation. So you all don't need to worry as such. I hope that's clear.
Sir.
Yeah.
So, sir, when we are doing our agenda-based research, since it's already stated beforehand that what are we going to discuss or negotiate upon, we have to just find what is like, we have to just go through various articles like given by different
various aspects of that particular topic. Now, what is the most credible source according to me, and which I'll be accepting? I'll come to this one part. Is Thomson Reuters the most credible source which I'll be considering, and UN documents. The two most, and UN press releases. That's it. Nothing more than this would be considered most credible. However, BBC would be secondary consideration. Not completely taken into order, secondary consideration. And to some extent, Al Jazeera. secondary consideration, not primary. But these three are primary. There is anyways no point of order on facts, so I don't think this contention issue would arise. I hope you all have understood.
Yes, sir.
Any more doubts? Delegate of Chile and all those who are first timers, did you all get a basic insight on how to research?
Yes.
I can't go too deep because I'm moderating you all for the 2 days, right? I hope you all understand my position as an executive board, right? Yes, so what yes. I can do is, after these 2 days, on the 1st November, after the last session, I can give you in-depth insight on how to research. But I would strongly urge you all to see that video. It's very clearly mentioned.
Sir, just last doubt.
No problem. Yeah, yeah, ma'am.
Yeah. So, before researching or something, I had asked my various friends who had participated in an MUN or something. So, they just said that, I just wanted to confirm, in country-based research, you should see your allies. I'm right now Chile, a delegate from Chile. So, I'll see who are my allies and what are the foreign policies of my country. And I just had one more doubt. We have to also see, when you're doing a country-based research, you have to also see the human rights situation in the country which you are representing.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Recommended. Highly recommended. Yes.
Okay. So will that question, if we are going away from the agenda, we are not talking about the agenda, rather we are talking about human rights in any other country as such. So will any other human rights crisis can be taken of any other country? Discussion can be taken place.
Ma'am, you can, but it's recommended to stick to the agenda, right? Or else the purpose of this committee stands unresolved, right? That's why.
Yes, yes. Okay.
Just a minute, delegates, just take this site down. This site is called bestdelegate.com. Everyone can go see this site. You all will get basic insight on how to research. So please go to bestdelegate.com and you'll get to know how to research. So, see, I can't give you all too much details on how to research since I'm moderating you all for 2 days. That's why I give you all a very rough insight. After the second day, we shall consider, having a discussion over this on how to research for an MUN. Any more doubts? If none, if you all understood the basic procedure, there are 3 to 4 things you all have to develop consensus on. I hope you all start working on those once the group gets opened up. You all can have consensus anyhow. Chit system is understood, I believe. And how we are going to proceed at is understood, I believe. Are there any more doubts? If there are none, we'll call it off. Or if there are doubts, we'll address them. Okay, I see none. So shall we call it off for the day?
Yes.
Okay. Fair, delegates. Fair. Thank you so much, delegates. Look forward to see you all on the day of the conference as well. If any, please develop consensus on 3-4 things which I have told, because the procedure by default expects consensus, some form of consensus. So work on those, lest I think regarding paperwork would be expected. Delegate of Sudan, yes, sir, your doubt.
It's not a doubt. How many motion do you expect in these 2 days conference? Can you?
No, sir. That's up to you all, sir. I need to know. I'll get to know on the day, how much you all will raise, how much you all will discuss. I am not in a position to give my. See, it's not about my expectations. It's about you all. You are the primary stakeholders. I am the moderator. Understand this. It's about how much you all want to discuss. It's not about how much I want. You're not here to satisfy what I want, right? Larger picture. As delegates, you all are here to gain consensus and provide solution on the issue at hand. Understand that.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Any more doubts? I think... Seeing none, I'll just wait for one more minute. If there are any doubts, you all can ask me at this point. If not, we'll just call it for the day, I think. the ROPs, I think you'll have understood to a good extent, I believe. So I think there are no doubts, so we'll call it for the day. Thank you, delegates. We'll meet on the day of the conference.